Hello everyone, this is our big data analytics project. Our chosen big data is Wikidata. So in the further slides we would be explaining about the Wikidata analytics. My name is Sundari and he is my teammate Suhas. So coming to the next first slide, the agenda, we would be actually dealing with the introduction about what's Wikidata, what it constitutes of, and then the storage part, like how we would be actually storing the dumps onto our HDFS system, and then the architecture which we are following in order to segregate the data dumps, and then the data ingestion part, which would be dealing with the enforceable schema scripts which we would be actually performing onto the data dumps, and then the queries which we would be dealing in on the Wikidata, and the best practices which we are using onto this project. So what's Wikidata? Wikidata is a collaboratively edited knowledge base collected from the people, and it's a full incremental backup taken on every month of each year. This was started in 2015. Wikidata actually supplies the data onto all the Wiki websites, name it as a Wikimedia or Wikipedia or anything. It actually constitutes of items, properties and values. So items would be the knowledgeable things which a user can query onto the Wikidata through Wikipedia as a user interface, and each item is associated with different properties and respective values for it, and then the dumps are available actually in JSON, XML and RDF formats. In this project we would be only using the JSON and XML formats, and we do have a summary table which constitutes of the properties and their corresponding IDs, property IDs, those PIDs, and a segregated form of PIDs for each category. And then you can have a glimpse of the Wikidata from where you can actually download the data. And then coming to the next slide, if you open the proposal document, you could actually see like what's the data dump size and all. And about the Wikidata storage, so we do have HDFS chip cloud and Unix chip cloud. So we do have the dumps on HDFS chip cloud as well as the Wikidata, Unix chip cloud. But the filtered data would be only the filtered data would be stored onto the HDFS chip cloud. For time being, like we have the entire dumps onto both of them. But in the later part, we would be actually filtering the data and then storing it onto the HDFS. And the links are displayed onto your screen. And then this is the proposed architecture which we'll be following for storing the data. This would be explained by Suhas.
Hello everyone. So this is a very high level architecture of data storage, and I mean how we are going to retrieve queries, all the stuff. And here this is, as mentioned, this is a Wikidata dump site. So here we have both formats, like we have URLs and we have files. So we will be using normal download for the XML and HTML files. And for the JSON files, we'll be directly using duplicate. So once we download the files to the local, we would be transferring to the Windows API to the Unix chip cloud. And here is a custom script which we have built. Here is a custom script which we have built, which deals with the automatically downloads by when we give the URL. And even transfer the files from Unix chip cloud to the Hadoop chip cloud. And as a big data technology, we have used Hive. So we would be storing all our data with comma separated files. And once the data is converted and schema check is done, it will be moved to the Hadoop chip cloud. And through Hive, we would be performing our queries, which we would discuss in the later part of the presentation. So as discussed, we are building a custom script. This is a Wikidata underscore load dot ksh, and basically this performs all these operations, which is data set download and data transfer, data conversion, and enforceable schema checking and error handling. So when it comes to the data set download, as I mentioned earlier, this script will it has like a user friendly interface. Like once you it will pop up this menu. So when you give the file name, it will directly transfer the file from Unix chip cloud to the Hadoop file system. And even on the URL, it will download from the website, and it will transfer to the Hadoop while performing all the uncompress and unzip options. And basically, we can do it. We are planning for putting a parameter for each of these operations. So for example, this would be D for download, and when we pass parameter D to the script, it will just download the, and transfer the scripts. And so when we say data transfer, it is like when the conversion and the schema validation says everything is successful, and the file is now, the comma separated file is ready for Hive operations, it would be transferring to the HDFS. So data conversion. So this would be the main part, and more time consuming, and we need to do more R&D on this part. And here, as we mentioned, we have the data set in this formats like XML, HTML, JSON, and we will be converting all this files to the CSV format. So we would be using awk commands, send commands, and we are even planning to use Python. So we need to do more analysis on that. So this is one sample how we performed send commands on the files for the to convert it to the CSV file. So this is the sample data set, and these are the Unix commands which are used to make the timestamp separately from the file, and username separately from the file, like using grep. And this command, print command, makes them side by side and converts them into the data user file. And later on, we will perform this set operations, which would be removing all the tags in the file, and this would be the output file, which is like the timestamp and username comma separated. And now this data will be moved to the HDFS for Hive operations. So when it comes to the enforceable schema checking, so once the file is converted into CSV file, and we will be filtering what are the required fields, and after filtering, we would be checking if it is in proper format, like the column name is as per the enforceable schema, even the data types, all those are checked using awk. These are the sample conditions, but we need to, we are even planning, as mentioned, we are planning to use Python, and we need to do more analysis on that. And so next is error handling, and this is something we are planning to put. Basically, when we say error handling, it is not with the data, but here in the case, we are talking about the file systems. When it comes to data, if we have any error with the schema or anything, it is something we need to check our code, or we need to check if the data set is changed or something. So once if the data set is changed, or suppose if the data set is changed, we need to change our code. But as per the standard, usually it would be the code problem. But here we are talking on the error handling on the, suppose if the system fails. So we are using a concept called status files. So it's something at a particular status, as this script performs various operations, in fail of any particular stage, like conversion and schema checking, it when you rerun it, it would only resume from this stage where it got failed. So this like example I'm showing here, like a status files, this is the conversion process. When conversion process completed, so it would touch conversion underscore complete. So suppose if the system failed during schema check or before schema check, it would check this touch file and resume, like okay, it will resume now the conversion is completed, now I need to start from the schema check. So this would time consume, and I mean it would save the time, and this is some of the best practices which we have followed. And coming to the latest slides regarding the queries, Sundari will be explaining.
we are dealing with four queries which would actually perform the analytics on Wikidata. So the first query would be the number of contributors during a duration of period. So it would actually provide an analytics to the Wikidata on the Wikidata as like what's the growth rate of Wikidata, because the contributors at the end are the actual providers of data. And the second one is the most frequent contributor to the data, which could be used by the Wikidata organization to reward the top persons who actually contributed more onto the Wikidata. And the third would be dealing with a list of items items which are not modified in a given period. So suppose if you take an example of like 2015 and 2016, so the items which were not modified in 2016 would be treated as the items which were not updated in 2016. So this would actually give them an insight of which items are most current trending topics. So the last query would be the count of properties in different categories. So each, like as discussed about Wikidata, so the entire Wikidata set is divided into different categories constituting of different properties in it. So this would actually give the Wiki organization a statistics about on which kind of categories they have to work on and increase the data dump size of which category. So the next slide would be explaining more about the query one. So for this query, the input file would be a logging file, which would be in an XML format. So after filtration, we would convert it into a CSV file with just two columns having the usernames and timestamps, which are the actual fields on which we would perform the operations. And the conversion tool would be the awk and cell scripting as discussed by Suhas. And the partition, and coming to the partition question, like we would be partitioning this on a timestamp. Like as you can see in the dataset example, we have a timestamp tag. So on that tag, like we would divide it into partitions, which could be used for faster access of the results of the query. And you can see the pseudo Hive code, which actually builds the tables. So I mean, we haven't completed the entire query. So this is just a starting point, like a way we could actually build a data set, filter a data set for query one. So coming to the batch views, like it could be interpreted in two ways. Like the first one is we have computed the batch views taking the point into consideration as like we should provide a faster result for a query. So in order to provide a faster access to the query, we could actually pre-compute some views about the query and then sum up all those details and then give the result for the query. So as our data is a static data, so we were just focusing on a faster retrieval of the data rather than like recomputing the data and creating the batch views. So coming to the pipe diagram of the query one, it would actually explain you about the entire working set of query one. So these are the XML files. Like we have like 6 to 8 logging files from which we would derive the timestamp, username, type, action, important fields from the XML as you have seen in the glimpse. And we would just filter the username and timestamp fields which are actually used in the query. So after filtering it, we would just merge those files and then group by it using the username. And then we would write a function to actually list down all the unique usernames and just produce the usernames who have contributed to the data. So coming to the second query, it would actually deal with the most frequent user who have contributed to the Wikidata. So this would also have a same kind of data format as the previous query, the XML format, and then the filtration data format format would be also the same as the first one, but the batch views computation would be different for this. So we would actually store the username for each month. We would be actually storing the username and his respective visit number based on the number of occurrences of usernames in the entire data dump, so that when it comes for a duration of period, we could actually sum up the individual months and give them the result. So as you can see in there, we would actually partition this also by timestamp column, which would actually store different data sets based on the partitions of month or year, and then these would be different buckets which would be used for faster retrieval of query too. And then you can see the pseudo hive code for this. And coming to the next part, like we would have a pipe diagram for this. It would also be similar to the first one, but rather than only grouping it by usernames, we would actually group it by username as well as the timestamp. And then we would actually write a function which would print the maximum count of each user, which would actually give the maximum number of count of each user, which would actually produce a frequent user for this query. And then coming to the third query, it would be the list of QIDs which are not modified in a given period. So the data format for this would be the JSON dump, and after filtration, the data format would be converted into .csv file having only the item field. So in the data set example, you can actually see like we have the ID number, which actually constitutes of the QID, and we have a call tag named modified, which actually stores the timestamp. So we would just filter these two values using awk and Python scripting, and store it in the table, and perform the later filtrations. And as you can see, like the batch views for this could be also computed for each month, and then those months could be summed up, and the result would be given. So for this, like coming to the pipe diagram of this query, it would actually deal with the filtration of different JSON files into .csv files, having like attributes like ID, type, labels, and description, which could be used in further processing of the data. And but only the ID and modified fields are filtered from it. But if needed, we could also use any of the description field from the previous CSV file, and then we would actually merge those files and group it by ID, and then we could actually perform a operation which could actually distinguish between the user QIDs which were edited in 2016 as well as the QIDs which were edited in 2015, and like we could actually subtract those things. As you know, like we have a minus operator in SQL, so we could just subtract the results from the two tables and just get the fields which are only present in 2016. So these would be the fields which are edited in 2016 but not in 2015. So coming to the fourth query, so it would be actually giving the count of properties in different categories. So the different categories would be the different categories which we have chosen would be the media, sports people, and elections. And as you know, like Wikidata has already given a summary table which would consist of the category and the respective properties and its values. So we would actually convert the .html file into .csv file with respective property ID with its value and the category which it belongs to. And we would actually check the occurrence of each property in the different JSON dumps, and like the number of occurrences of the properties would be actually summed up and would be used for giving the count of properties for different categories. So like you can actually see the example, a snippet of how the categories are segregated on the HTML page, and this is the pseudo hive code which you have used. These would be partitioned based on the property ID. So the different property IDs would be summed up into different buckets. Coming to the batch views, for each list of properties would be computed by each category, and then if there are two or three categories being asked by the user, then those three categories count will be summed up and given as an output for the user. So coming to the pipe diagram of this query, it would be actually dealing with the same as like converting it into a .csv file. We would actually have two states in this. First one is combining the JSON files, and one would be a reference table or a key table from the summary file. So it would actually, the summary file would be converted into a CSV file as discussed, it would be just filtered by the mentioned categories in the query, and all those properties which we have counted from different queries would be summed up, merged into a single file with the categories in the summary table. So these two would be clubbed up, and for each category the property IDs which have been repeated in the different JSON dumps would be listed out after the stage, and then it would be grouped by the categories and property IDs and the different categories, and its respective count would be displayed. And the lowest count of properties in a category would be treated as a data dump, treated as a category which has low amount of data and which needs to be updated. So coming to the next thing, we actually have a project plan being built for this project. Which and the best practices which we are using in this project, so it would be dealt by Suhas.
So the best practice comprises of work plan and the project plan. So coming to the work plan, so currently we have like challenge like only one user, one teammate can only store the data sets, and others would be won't be carrying those data sets. But still we came up with like individual working directories. So we would be working on the task parallelly on like the data injection and the queries part. But what we will be doing is like we will be just taking the reference of small data chunks and build the code and try on the huge data set on the later stage. So this is make sure that we everyone do parallelly all their tasks so that we can accomplish the goal. And we do peer reviews to check the code standards, all the stuff. And we do internal review to see when the queries hit actually the huge data set, and we would be following this best practices as part of the work plan. And coming to the project plan, so currently we started this project on like doing the data set research on the stuff with 23rd Jan, and so I would be showing further on the Microsoft project plan. So we started on like in the so this is would be the data set research which was on January 23rd stuff, and these are the tasks which we will be doing, and these are the assigning, and with this make sure that we do the separate all the queries parallelly on their respective work directories. And coming down would be the all the tasks, all the how we are going to perform, and this would be like before the initial date of the review, and we would be spending a whole chunk of the internal review and the preparation for the review. And this is very high level, and later on part we would be changing according to the task completions. So this makes sure that we have a complete plan of the project, how to complete and who, and the task divided on which person does what task, and I think this will help. And this is pretty much about this Wikidata analytics. Thank you very much. And please send us your queries to our mail IDs. We will answer them. Thank you.